this video gets you started with OptiLife. So there will be two parts. One would be your web login and the other would be your Flebo mobile. So to get started, you have to log in into the OptiLife portal. And first step is, after the Flebo's download, install and register on the OptiLife app, then only you can add them to your team. In case you get a screen like this with the this is a half thing where just the arrows have come, it is internet connection and it is not uploaded properly. In that case, you just need to log out and log in again. So you can see the full screen has come now with the whole drop down menu. And once they have registered their mobile number and email ID on the OptiLife app and exited, after that you can add them to your team. So for the registration, they can use any email ID, and same email ID can be used by the whole team also. So you have to click on collection agents. After they have registered on their mobile, you can go to collection agents and click on add collection agent. Once you click on add collection agent, you have to write the name of the Flebo here, the mobile number on which he has registered the OptiLife app, and click on add. Once you click on add, you will see that person in the list of your Flebos or the list of your collection agents. So here you can see that these are the two collection agents that are added here, and currently none of them are online. Number of online collection agents is zero. Once they are online, it will be highlighted in green. So I'll just show on the Flebo's mobile. This is the OptiLife app that has been installed and registered, and I'll show what we mean by a login and logout. Once I click on the OptiLife app, it means it is a login. This is a simple login. They just need to click the OptiLife app, and they can also keep it running in the background. Even if the phone is locked, the app keeps on running. So you can see immediately, once the app has been clicked in, the status has changed immediately to green, which means that this person is logged in. And a logout is nothing but I click again, and once you do a right click, that is exit OptiLife, once you click on yes, this will be a logout. Then you cannot see the movement of your Flebos, where they are, where their current location is, and you cannot also assign collections or visits to them. So it is very essential. The basic step is to keep them logged in during your work timings, whenever your shift starts. Currently, there are no active collections assigned to this Flebo. So I'll show how to assign a collection. You have to go to collections, click on create collection. This is for creating one by one collection, as in when you get requests from customers. In case you have 50-60 visits that are already accumulated for the next day, you can do a bulk upload, and a bulk upload is nothing but an upload through an Excel file. So that Excel file you can choose and click on bulk upload Excel file. But for one by one creation, as in when you are getting the customer request for collection, you can click on create collection. This can be for a B2B collection, it can also be for a B2C collection. So for B2B collection, you have to put the lab name, the lab phone number is must, it has to be any 10 digit number, lab name, address has to be separated by comma. And then if you have any collection amount, you can mention that here. Payment mode has to be cash by default. If you have a payment URL gateway, we'll come to that. That can be selected for sending a payment gateway link to the customer. Assignment mode, you have to click on manual. Manual means the drop down of your collection agents would come. And once that has put here that are in star, you can select them. That means they are online. You can see that this guy is online here. The OptiLife app is running in his phone, and you can assign him immediately. So I'll just show how to assign it. you have to select from deferred, you have to select now. This is for showing a an instant assignment, and if it is for later, then it will come with a date and time. So here it is now. Under deferred you have now. If it is now, it will be assigned immediately on the mobile. I'll show you. And if it is for a later date, you can do it even for tomorrow, day after. You can pick up from the calendar any date and time and put the time here, change the time, put the date and click on create. Then the assignment status would be deferred. Deferred means it is for later. It will not show now. So I'll just show for now and I'll click on assign. I'll click on create. So immediately there was a buzz on this phone and there was a sound, and the collection that was created has immediately come on the Flebo's mobile. So now what actions does the Flebo need to take? First thing is, by using this, if it is, it converts this green pin, converts this address into a point on the Google Maps, and it will help him drive to a new location that is unknown to him. So he can click on that and reach the customer location. So he has to follow the instructions that are provided by Google and follow them and reach the location. Then he can directly call the customer through this page to understand if the customer is available or not. And after that, he has to change. Once he starts moving from the diagnostic to the customer location, or from the last customer location to the next customer location, he has to click to slide to in transit. That is, he is moving towards the customer location. So this OK message has to come and he has to click on close. That's it. After that, he can do confirm payment, which can be an OTP based payment. Feedback is there, capture image, so he can take any image also. He can upload any image or choose from library and click on OK. So save. This is how the image is captured. Up to 5 images can be captured. He can also reschedule any visit. Okay, this page, he can either cancel the visit or he can reschedule. If he reschedules, he has to pick up a date, new date and time, click on OK. On that date and time, automatically this collection would be reassigned. He can then take the customer signature on his mobile. So this is a digital proof of service. And there is also a barcode reader in case you are pre-scanning the samples with the barcodes. So once this is done, he can confirm payment also. So this will be pre-populated. The amount is coming from the from whatever has been input by the admin team, and then the customer name and the mobile will be pre-populated. So if he clicks on send OTP, it will say please provide the OTP. This OTP has been sent to the customer for verifying that this collection amount is correct. So let's go to all collections, live collections, because it is not completed. It will show under live collections. You can see payment status is initiated, and whatever images have been captured, whatever signature is captured, all that will be reflected here. And payment status is initiated. When he clicked on in transit, this is how the SMS would go to the customer. Once the customer opens the SMS link, he will see that this is he'll be shown there what is the ETD of the Flebo. So he can see that, and he has to provide the customer OTP here. So customer is getting a message like this: thanks for making a technician. When he clicked on in transit, this is how the message went: a technician from your diagnostic is scheduled to visit, track the technician live. So he can see the technician live. The customer can see the technician live. Whatever I showed from the back end, how the customer sees, this is how the customer will see. And thanks for making payment of rupees 100 to your diagnostic. Share this OTP if the billed amount is correct. So 5388 is the OTP that has to be shared with the phlebo. The customer has to share. So once he shares that OTP, it will show that this is okay and close. And we can see immediately at the back end, the status will change. We click on live collections. From initiated, the payment has immediately changed to paid. And he has to, then his work is done there. Before leaving the customer location, he has to slide this to completed, and immediately this visit will disappear from his mobile. Because this job is done, you can see it is showing no active collections. And at the back end, now you live collections, you can see, now you will see nothing under live collections. Because it is completed, you can see it under all collections. So this is how the basic flow is. Thank you.